Okay, well, we're on the front line, and this is the dividing point between Al-Qaeda, which they call Al-Nusra. They keep changing the name, but it's Al-Qaeda. This is the same group that attacked the Twin Towers on 9/11, killed 3,000 Americans. They all burned to death, or they leaped from the Twin Towers a quarter of a mile down so that they could escape the flames. We're in a building. It's a six-story building, but it has very good observation. You can see here, we have a soldier who is observing with the telescopic lens, and it's mounted up high so that it's very difficult for snipers to hit him, because he has a distance. He's able to stay down low where he has some cover. We have organizations like this all through the building. There are courts with soldiers ready to defend against the enemy. The important thing to remember is that this is the dividing line right here. If you walk across the street, this is Al-Qaeda. And the individual who is in charge of the entire army, the commander-in-chief, is Al-Julani. Al-Julani was a major commander in ISIS. He held Nineveh province in Iraq, and then he was elevated to where he is the senior Al-Qaeda commander on earth. He commands the biggest terror army in the world, and this is their final stand. This is their last place in Idlib province, where they have been cornered and trapped. It should be a time when people in the United States and everyone who's concerned about terrorism would be ecstatic. This is a wonderful time for us, because we need revenge for what happened on 9/11. We have fought a war of terror for 7 years with nothing to show for it. Well, 17 years it's been, and nothing to show. And yet here the Syrian army and their allies have cornered all of the terrorists in one place. And of course, there are many civilians who have been trapped. They're used as human shields by the terrorists. And so we have to liberate them. The Syrian army is very careful to limit civilian casualties. I've looked at the figures. Civilian casualties are remarkably low, considering the fact that we're in urban combat. People die in urban combat. It's a very brutal type of combat. We stand right now on a part of Aleppo that used to be held by a huge force of terrorists. They were finally trapped, and they tried to break out with hundreds and hundreds of tanks, with thousands of men. It was one of the great battles, probably the great battle of the war. Today, they're much diminished, and yet we have tens of thousands of terrorists who hold this last refuge, this last place, and they have to be destroyed. And so it's for the Syrian army to destroy them, and at the same time to try to protect the civilians as much as possible. They are trying to get the civilians out through humanitarian corridors. Actually, thousands of them have already gotten out. I'm sure many more want to get out. We're here with two of our generals, two of our brigadier generals, who are in command of the forces here. I will tell you, just looking around, that the Syrian armed forces are professional, they're highly trained, and they're under orders to minimize civilian casualties. This is much different than the people on the other side. On the other side, they're ordered to murder, to kill, to rape. This is their policy. It comes down from on top, is to kill the people. So we're on the right side. This is a time when the civilized world should be celebrating, because Al-Jilani is the head of all the rebel forces, all of them. So they are all Al-Qaeda. ISIS has a role to play. They're one of the three major units, Al-Qaeda. There's others, but they are all under the central command of Al-Jilani. The United States has a $10 million bounty on the head of Al-Jilani because he is considered to be such a vile and vicious and horrible terrorist that this bounty is there. Hopefully there will be some of the Syrian army soldiers who can say, hey, you owe me $10 million. We'll see whether the United States is willing to pay when the Syrians bring down Al-Jilani. It is my personal hope that he is not captured. We don't need a trial. We need for them to be destroyed on the field of battle. But anyway, we're going to go around. We're going to see some of the Syrian soldiers. Very courageous, very heroic. They have fought for 7 years, going on 8 years, against two-thirds of the military and industrial might of the world. The enemy have been recruited from 102 countries. They are the worst of the worst terrorists. They slaughter, they kill, they actually set up slave markets. They sell women, they sell little girls. Little girls bring the highest price for the terrorists. There's nothing on the Syrian side. The Syrian army is very civilized. It acts appropriately in everything that it does. And so this will be the last great battle. Once this is done, I think that the Kurds will give up on the idea that they will somehow dominate the northeast part of the country. They'll realize that the war is over at this point. So we're going to go around today. We're going to be talking with some of the Syrian soldiers, or at least looking at them. We'll get a better view where you can see out here, and you can see enemy-held territory right across the street. The street is a demarcation line. Here is the Syrian army. Over there is Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda, the very same people who brought down the Twin Towers and the Pentagon on 9/11, they're out there, and these men are going to bring them down. So, thank you.
Thank you.
So you might take a picture out through the.
Okay.